I want to give confidence to Ugandans that there is no internal contradiction whatsoever that will disintegrate the party, because it has stood the test of time. That's one. Two, we have had disagreements since 1954. And in Democratic Party, that is healthy, because the foundation on which we were constructed as a party includes, among others, the freedom of expression, freedom of members to express their views, regardless of whether the leadership agrees with such views of members or not. They have the liberty to speak. And that has formed the strength, one of the strengths of the party. There are many political parties in Uganda where you cannot confront a leader. The leader is a supremo. I know you know some of these parties. It is only a Democratic Party where the topmost leader can be ridiculed, can be insulted by members of his own party, and no attempt is made to curtail the freedom of such members to express their views. This time round, we have an internal contradiction. An internal contradiction in terms of ideas as a party. Some members of the party are saying the cooperation agreement is good. And some members are saying that the cooperation agreement is not good. I am not going to give you my view, because the position I hold, I speak for both groups in the Democratic Party. The issues that are raised by those that do not agree with the cooperation agreement include, among others, that by the President General joining government, he ceased to be the president of the Democratic Party, and therefore he should vacate the office of the President General. That is one. I will address it. The second issue that arose recently, that the National Executive Committee that was convened on the 14th day of October 2022 was not legal. It was not legally binding. I will get to that also. The other issue that is raised by the members who are not for the agreement, though they may not expressly state it, the fear that the other person on the other side may not fulfill the requirements of the agreement by performing the obligations on his part. Let me address these three issues to give clarity such that there is no haze anymore in the minds of people. Our constitution, the Democratic Party constitution, is clear on how a member ceases to be a member of the Democratic Party. These include, among others, when a member becomes deceased, he ceases to be a member of the Democratic Party. We cannot have a party of dead people. That was the spirit. Secondly, A person ceases to be a member when he resigns. When a person resigns, he ceases to be a member. The third issue, or the third way through which a person loses membership, is when a person misbehaves and be presented before National Executive Committee sitting as the disciplinary committee of the party. And he or she is sentenced. And members of the National Executive Committee sitting as the disciplinary committee finds it appropriate to dismiss such a member. He ceases to be a member of the Democratic Party. The last way through which a member ceases to be a member of the Democratic Party is when he joins another registered political party in the country. Back to the issue that the colleagues give of Honorable Norbert Mao being in government, so he ceases to be a member. I wish to state it in clear terms that government and a political party are two different things. Though it is a political party that is ruling, that forms the government or the ruling government, but that does not mean that everybody that is in government has to be a member of the ruling party. In this case, we have NRM as the ruling party in Uganda. And we have the government. The government is formed of three arms. We have the legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. Should we say that whoever that is in government is a member of the National Resistance Movement Party? I don't want to believe so. Because if it were so, then members of parliament, one would infer that they belong to National Resistance Movement Party because they belong to one arm of government. The only difference, I repeat and iterate the same here, that the only difference between Honorable Norbert Mao and members of parliament, among whom others are on the other part accusing him to have joined NRM, is that Honorable Norbert Mao sits in one arm of government, which is the executive, and the members of parliament sit in another arm of government, which is the legislature. The similarity is that all of these two are paid by the taxpayers' money. It is actually not surprising that Ugandans are being confused by this, because the situation that we have lived in as a country for the past, I would say, 37 years, is to the effect that the way business was run in government, one would actually fail to qualify the distinction between the NRM party and the government. But there is a difference. Now, as the Democratic Party, we think this is our duty to draw a distinction in the minds of Ugandans, regardless of the negative energies, to keep the two merged. we should draw a distinction between government and the ruling party. The Honorable Norbert Mao is serving in government. He is not in National Resistance Movement. He has not acquired a political party membership card in the National Resistance Movement. Therefore, his membership in the Democratic Party remains untampered with and intact.